We shall now discuss series of positive terms. The definition of series of positive term is series un is said to be a series of positive terms if un is greater than 0 for all n belong to n. That is, a series said to be a series of positive term if each and every term of the series is positive. It's a self-explanatory. A series is said to be a series of positive term if every term of the series is positive. Symbolically, we write series un belongs to S plus. S stands for series, plus stands for positive. Therefore, whenever we write series un belongs to S plus, it means the series un is a series of positive terms. That is, each and every term of the given series is greater than 0. That is positive. Let the series of un be a series of positive terms. Then Sn. We know Sn is the first n terms of the given series. Sn is equals to the partial sum. Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus so on un. What is Sn plus 1? We simply replace n by n plus 1 in Sn. Right? Therefore, Sn plus 1 will be u1 plus u2 plus so on plus un plus un plus 1. Now, u1 plus u2 plus u1 plus un plus 1 is Sn plus 1. That is, Sn plus 1 has one term more than Sn. What about the terms u1 plus u2 plus so on plus un, which is highlighted in red color? That is nothing but Sn. And hence, Sn plus 1 is equals to Sn plus un plus 1. Now transposing this Sn to the left hand side. And hence what happened? Sn plus 1 minus Sn is equals to un plus 1. What is un plus 1? Un plus 1 is the n plus 1th term of the given series. What type of series? Series of positive terms. Therefore, every term is positive. And hence, its n plus 1th term, namely un plus 1, is also positive. It is true for all n belong to n. It's true for 100, true for 101, true for anything, true for anything. Therefore, this implies Sn plus 1 is greater than Sn. That is, Sn plus 1 minus Sn is greater than 0. Bring this Sn to the right hand side. Then what happened? Sn plus 1 will be greater than Sn. So this implies Sn plus 1 is greater than Sn for all n belong to n. Then what can we say about this? Sn plus 1 is greater than Sn. It is true for every n. That is, the sequence Sn is monotonically increasing sequence. And hence now we conclude that since every monotonic sequence converges or diverges, a series of positive terms is either converges or diverges but never oscillates. That is, every series of positive terms is monotonically increasing. And a monotonically increasing sequence either converges or diverges. Therefore, a series of positive terms is either converges or diverges but never oscillates. That is, one of the behaviors of a series is ruled out. What is that? One of the behaviors of the series, namely oscillatory, is ruled out. Therefore, now we have only two behaviors. What are they? either the series of positive term converges or diverges. Let us going to have one more conclusion. Let us wait for that. We know that corresponding sequence of partial sum of series always monotonically increasing sequence. Every monotonically increasing sequence which is bounded above converges to its supremum. A monotonically decreasing sequence which is not bounded above diverges to plus infinity. These are all we have discussed in sequences. Basing upon these three, the above three observations, we say that a series of positive term either converges or diverges to plus infinity, because none of the terms of the series is negative and hence it cannot diverge to minus infinity. Thus, a series of positive term is either convergent or divergent and diverges to plus infinity. Thus, we have only two things. In fact, we can say there are five behaviors of a series. One is convergent, other one is divergent. In divergent, we have two things. One is diverges to plus infinity, diverges to minus infinity. The third one is oscillatory, in which two cases are there? Oscillate finitely, oscillate infinitely. Thus, there are five chances. The chances are converges, diverges to plus infinity, diverges to minus infinity, oscillatory finitely, oscillating infinitely. Out of five, three are ruled out now. We are ruled out now. Therefore, a series of positive terms has only two behaviors. What are they? Either it converges or diverges to plus infinity. If a series un of positive term is such that un, the limit of un is not equal to zero ascending infinity, then the series un diverges and diverges to plus infinity. Plus infinity. And the un is sn minus 1. Or un plus 1 will be sn plus 1 minus sn. Thus, to prove that a series of positive terms converges, it is enough to show that the corresponding sequence of partial sums is bounded above. If it is not bounded above, the series of positive terms diverges to plus infinity. So only one thing you have to check. Only one thing, that is the corresponding sequence of partial sum is bounded above or not. If it is bounded above, the series is convergent. If it is not bounded above, the series is divergent and diverges to plus infinity. So in order to see whether series of positive terms is convergent or divergent, it is sufficient to see the sequence of partial sum is bounded or unbounded. But it is not easy to check whether it is bounded or unbounded. Simple thing is finding limit of the sequence Sn as n tends to infinity. Now, we are going to prove a very, very important theorem, namely axillary series or hyperharmonic series or P series. Just now we discussed harmonic series, the series 1 by n, which diverges. But here, this, the name of this theorem is axillary series or hyperharmonic series, or it is called P series. What is the statement of this theorem? The statement of this theorem is the series 1 by n to the power p, where n is running from 1 to infinity, is equals to 1 plus 1 by 2 power p, because 1 power p is 1, therefore 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus so on, where p is any real number. P can be positive, P can be negative, P even zero, P can be even zero. So P is any real number. So this series converges if P is greater than 1, and diverges if P is less than or equals to 1. Less than or equals to 1. This series is called axillary series. Why it is called axillary series? What is the meaning of axillary? Even in a differential equation, whenever a differential equation is given, next we write an axillary equation. We use Young. That is Young d squared y by dx squared plus dy by dx plus 1 equal to 0. Can be written as m squared plus m plus 1. Instead of writing d squared y by dx squared, which involves 7 characters. It consists of 7 characters. D squared y divided by d squared x. The 7 characters can be replaced by only 2 characters, namely m squared. Next is dy by dx. Dy by dx consists of 5 characters. D is a character, y is a character, divide by is a character, d is a character, x is a character. So dy by dx consists of 5 characters. The 5 character is replaced by a single character, namely m plus 1 equal to 0. Thus, d squared y by dx squared plus dy by dx plus 1 equal to 0 consists of 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 5, 13 plus 1, 14 plus 1, 15, 16, 17 characters are there. D squared y by dx squared plus dy by dx plus 1 equal to 0 consists of 17 characters. The 17 character is replaced by only simply m squared plus m plus 1 equal to 0. Such a big equation required 17 characters that can be replaced by only 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 7, 8 characters. So the 17 characters reduced to 8 characters. And the equation m squared plus m plus 1 equal to 0 is called axillary equation. Then what is the meaning of axillary equation? When you say axillary, the meaning of axillary is helping. The meaning of axillary is helping. Just now we discussed a harmonic series. What's the harmonic series? Series 1 by n. But this is called hyperharmonic series. Why it is called hyper? What do you mean by hyper? Hyper is more, high, super. The meaning of hyper is super, high, more. There, in harmonic series, we have just 1 by n. No P at all. But when you say hyper, it involves every real number. Therefore, you discuss about each and every power of n. Therefore, it's called hyperharmonic series. This is also called P series. You know why it's called P series? because here p is involved 1 by n power p, and hence the theorem is known as auxiliary series or hyperharmonic series or p series. The statement of this series is the series 1 by n power p, where n is running from 1 to infinity, p is any real number, converges if p is greater than 1, and diverges if p is less than or equals to 1. Let us prove this theorem. Whenever we want to check the behavior of a series, what we do? We have to check the behavior of the sequence of its partial sums. As I told you, for any problem or any theorem, to check the convergence of a series. Convergence means, again I tell you, it is not convergent. Convergence is nothing but behavior of a series. So to check the convergence of a series, we check the convergence of sequence of its partial sums. Therefore, let sequence SN be a sequence of partial sums of the series 1 by n power p, where Sn, what is Sn? Sn is the partial sum. What is the partial sum? Nothing but the first n terms of the given series. Therefore, Sn is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus so on plus 1 by n power p. It has got two cases. What are the two cases? Case 1 is p is greater than 1. Case 2 is p is less than or equal to 1. Now case 1, let p be greater than 1. Now these n terms, what are they? 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus so on 1 by n power p. These n sums can be grouped as follows. Now group the series, the above series, as follows. 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p. Next term is 1 by 4 power p. So let us start with 1 by 4 power p plus 1 by 5 power p plus 1 by 6 power p plus 1 by 7 power p plus so on. That is, here we have one term, here two terms, here four terms. The next one will be 8 terms. It is like 2 power 0 is one term, 2 power 1, two terms, 2 power 2, four terms, 2 power 3, 8 terms. 8 terms. Next term, next group will consist of 2 power 4, 16 terms. Next term will consist of 2 power 5, 32 terms. So on. So we consider the number of terms, the group in group, number of terms as 2 power n, where n is from 0 to any number. Therefore, 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 5 power p plus 1 by 6 power p plus 1 by 7 power p plus so on. Now, which is greater, 3 or 2? 3 is greater than 2. 3 is greater than 2. What is p? Greater than 1. Therefore, 3 power p is greater than 2 power p. 3 is greater than 2. Since the power p is greater than 1, so 3 power p is greater than 2 power p. Write its reciprocal. Whenever we write a reciprocal in which inequality is involved, that has to be reversed. Therefore, 1 by 3 power p is less than 1 by 2 power p. 1 by 3 power p is less than 1 by 2 power p. We know 1 by 2 power p is equal to 1 by 2 power p. But 1 by 3 power p is less than 1 by 2 power p. Therefore, the second group, the second bracket, 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p is less than 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 2 power p. What about next term? 1 by 4 power p is equals to 1 by 4 power p. But 1 by 5 power p is less than 1 by 4 power p, as we have proved here, as we have shown here, as I explained here. 1 by 5 power p will be less than 1 by 4 power p. 1 by 6 power p is less than 1 by 4 power p. 1 by 7 power p is less than 1 by 4 power p. What about next term? The next group we have 1 by 8 power p. 1 by 8 power p is equal to 1 by 8 power p. But 1 by 9 power p is less than 1 by 8 power p. 1 by 10 power p is less than 1 by 8 power p. This equation, this right hand side of the above equation becomes less than 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power 2 power p plus 1 by 4 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 power p plus 1 by 8 power p, 8 terms. This is equals to 1 plus, how many terms are here? There are 2 terms, each term is 1 by 2 power p. Therefore, 2 by 2 power p. We have 1 by 4 power p, how many terms are there? There are 4 terms, therefore 4 by 4 power p. Plus 1 by 8 power p, how many terms are there? 8 terms. Therefore, 8 by 8 power p plus so on, plus so on. That is, S n is equal, less than, equal. Therefore, S suffix n is less than 1 plus 2 by 2 power p plus 4 by 4 power p plus 8 by 8 power p, so on. That is, Sn is less than 1 plus 2 by 2 by p plus 4 by 4 power p plus 8 by 8 power p plus so on. Now, this is equal to 1 plus. Bring these 2 to the denominator. What happened? 2 power p into 2 power minus 1, that becomes 2 power p minus 1. Bring this 4 to the denominator, what happened? 4 power p into 4 power minus 1. Therefore, it becomes 4 power p minus 1. Similarly, bring this 8 to the denominator, it becomes 1 by 8 power p minus 1 plus so on. Thus, Sn is less than 1 plus 1 by 2 power p minus 1 plus. We know that 2 squared is 4. 2 squared is 4. Therefore, this can be written as 1 by 2 to the power p minus 1 power 2. We know that 2 power 3 is 8. Therefore, 1 by 8 power p minus 1 can be written as 1 by 2 to the power p minus 1 power 3 plus so on. Have we seen this type of sequence series anywhere? Yes. Yes, it is a geometric series. So, right hand side is a geometric series with the common ratio. How do you find the common ratio? The common ratio can be found by using the formula second term by first term. The general formula is nth term by n minus 1th term. But for problems or theorems, very easy to find R by taking second term divided by first term. It is called common ratio. Why? If you take T2 by T1, same as T3 by T2, same as T4 by T3, same as Tn by Tn minus 1. We take ratio here. T2 by T1 is a ratio, and all the ratio will give the same value, common value. Therefore, R is called common ratio. Common ratio. Therefore, common ratio is T2 by T1. What is T2? 1 by 2 power P minus 1. What is T1? 1. Therefore, T2 by T1 is, look at this. What is T2? 1 by 2 power P minus 1. So, 1 by 2 power P minus 1 by T1. T1 is 1. T1 is 1. Therefore, it is R equals to 1 by 2 power P minus 1. Since 2 power P minus 1 is greater than 1. Yes, it is greater than 1. This implies 1 by 2 power P minus 1 is less than 1. Less than 1. Therefore, we have R is nothing but 1 by 2 power P minus 1, which is less than 1. Which is less than 1. And hence, the geometric series converges. Since R is less than 1, we know that a geometric series converges if modulus of R is less than 1. Since here R is less than 1, this geometric series is convergent. And it converges to the limit, the formula is A by 1 minus R. That is equal to, what is A? A is 1 by 1 minus, what is R? R is 1 by 2 power P minus 1. Therefore, this series is converging and converges to 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 power P minus 1, which is a real number. We call this K. We call this K. Therefore, Sn is less than K. Sn is less than K for all. For all. N. This implies the sequence Sn is bounded above. Just now in the previous result, we discussed that if the series of positive term is bounded above, it is convergent. If it is not bounded above, it is divergent. Right? Here the series sequence Sn of the partial sum of the given series of positive term is bounded above. And hence, by that result, the series 1 by n power p, where p is greater than 1, is a series of positive terms, and the sequence Sn of its partial sum is monotonically increasing. Hence, monotonically increasing sequence which is bounded above is convergent. Therefore, the sequence Sn of its partial sum is convergent, and hence the series 1 by n power p is convergent when p is greater than 1. This completes the case 1. What is case 2? Case 2 is much easier, very simple. Case 2 is P is less than or equal to 1. Let P be less than or equal to 1. Since P is less than or equal to 1, N power P is less than or equals to N. Right? It's reciprocal. 1 by N power P is greater than or equal. Greater than or equal. That is reversed. Greater than or equal to 1 by N for all N. For all N. So, 1 by n power p is greater than or equals to 1 by n. What is Sn? 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus so on plus 1 by n power p. What is p? Less than or equals to 1. Less than or equal to 1. So, 2 power p is less than or equal to 2. This implies 1 by 2 power p is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. What about 1 by 3 power p? Greater than or equal to 1 by 3. What is 1 by 4 power p? 2x are equal to 1 by 4. 1 by 4. Therefore, this becomes now, this is the right hand side is greater than or equals to 1 plus 1 by 2 power p. That is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. What about 1 by 3 power p? Greater than or equal to 1 by 3. 1 by n power p, all we have written here. 1 by n power p is greater than or equal to 1 by n. Thus, the right hand side is greater than or equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 power p plus 1 by 3 power p plus so on plus 1 by n power p. We call it as L. This expression we call it as L. It's a real number called as L. That is, Sn is greater than or equals to L. L. We know that the sequence Sn is bounded above if Sn is greater than or equal to k for all n. For all n. But what do you get here? We got the other one, the other way. What is that? Sn is greater than or equals to L. Therefore, we say the sequence Sn is not bounded above. The sequence is not bounded above. We know that the sequence is the series is the series of positive terms. Now, the sequence of partial sum, Sn is not bounded above. Not bounded above. And hence, the series is the series of positive terms which is not bounded above. Therefore, it is divergent, and hence the sequence Sn is divergent. Therefore, the corresponding series is also divergent. Hence, the given axillary series or the hyperharmonic series or the P series, namely series 1 by n power p, where p is greater, p is a real number, converges if p is greater than 1, diverges if p is less than or equals to 1. This is the proof of this important result. Hereafter, whenever we do a problem or a theorem, normally the given problem will be of the form series 1 by n power p. 1 by n power p. Based on the value of p, based on the value of p, we can conclude that whether the series is convergent or divergent. So this theorem is going to help you a lot for us. Help you a lot for us. Whether we are going to do theorem, prove a theorem or problems, this theorem is going to help us to find the convergence of the given series. Therefore, it is called axillary series. This is supposed to be an important series for solving your problems.